Welcome to the Success Church. Tune in. I'm Overseer Prophet Derek Gillespie, and we are live in our 5 a.m. prayer meeting on Good Friday. Yeah, my friend would have been canceled. Just thought I'd tell you that. They just keep my spirit. You know, my friend room.
Okay.
It's been canceled.
That's power.
You know, who's going to preach? Man, is you crazy?
Wow.
You know how long it'll be before I decide that? Jesus. I ain't planning no wheels. You know, we're going to ride around planning their wheels, planning out the obituaries.
Just doing a bunch of stuff.
Just doing it. Just all over the board.
With that
deal. I'm talking about that. Think that is right. Yes. I'm planning. Reverend Smith is going to do the obituary.
Yeah,
man, I ain't planning on going nowhere. No time soon. My funeral has been canceled. Someone may be battling with a sickness. I tell you, oh my God is a healer. God gave me a new testimony. You ask you about your testimony. You tell me what God did back in 96. It's 2019. He ain't did nothing lately. God is a healer. Lenora tossed on the line. God is a healer. One thing was in the casket, but God is a healer.
Jesus.
Can we testify, Lenora? Your funeral will be canceled, girl.
Jesus.
I ain't just saying this. This is real.
Somebody didn't get a chance to say that.
Somebody didn't get a chance to say that. Somebody planned their last 8 months. About what the doctor said.
You got
6 months to live, and then they start planning. Well, we're gonna do the wedding this. Cause we ain't got for 6 months. It's just crazy. That's 6 months to believe.
It's mental,
Lord. Oh Lord. Deliver my people, Lord. Deliver us from religiosity and tradition. This old tradition. This old tradition is putting people in the grave before time. Oh, but Christ is risen this morning. Come on, somebody say
Christ
is risen in
me.
And I'm about to believe him.
My
God.
Okay.
See, you can only live through Christ. You can't live in Mike. Mike gonna die, but Christ is gonna live. And so you got to switch from your humanity to your divinity. You got to look at the Bible not as theologically, not look at the Bible theologically, but look at it psychology. See, we got to switch. That theological, it worked back then during the slave days when they were singing Dr. Watts when they didn't have nothing else. But we are in the millennium. Folks, it's coming up every day, but it's through the switching of the mind. Get out of that theologian aspect of the Bible. Get in that psychology part of the Bible. Let's take the Bible for exactly what it says. And if it says I can live and not die, if it says I can do all things through Christ, if it can say that if any man be in Christ, get out of himself and be in Christ. He's a new creature. All old things are passed away. Let's take that for exactly what they're saying. Hallelujah. Sit up on that old glory train. Let's pray for the sin and shit in this. Man, I ain't with none of that. I ain't with that. Y'all can have that. We shut down the sick and shut in list. Well, listen, for the next 3 days, you need to just lay in your bed and declare that you shall live
and not die.
Okay, declares the Lord. Goodbye.
Oh.
That's what needs to start happening in church. Now, for the mothers that's, 80, 90 years old, okay, that's good. But hey, I'm still going to tell you, too. Because it ain't over. Oh, my God. It ain't over.
We watching.
It ain't over. Mother, it ain't over. salvation, on what I'm believing God for, on what God is doing in my house. The devil don't want to let my house go.
Okay.
You hear that? He don't want to let my house go. But I've just been speaking life. Thank you, God.
Thank you, God.
And meditating.
That's it.
You feel me? I understand this frustration in the air.
Yeah.
Hey. But we shall live.
Yeah.
And not die.
That's it.
We shall live and not die. Here's the biggest, I want to say this thing before we get to the scripture. Here's the biggest misconception about Christian life. When you ask a believer, so what do you want from God? Let that rest. What do you want from God? They'll say, well, you know, I want some money. Now, what do you want? What are you praying for? What you praying for? See, that's a big misconception, because here you go. Ain't nothing to ask you if you don't actually know what you praying for. You just praying just to live from day to day, from play to play. Now, that ain't nothing. You got to be specific. So I'm going to help y'all this morning.
Help.
Because it was a question for me. So what I want for the Lord, from the Lord, is your blessing.
Yeah.
Anything I want is under the blessing. I want your blessing, Lord.
It's on my life. I want it.
I want your blessing. I'm coming here for your blessing. I'm sowing and giving for your blessing. I'm serving for your blessing. I'm receiving your blessing. I'm believing just the blessing of the Lord. Blessing the Lord makes me rich. You trying to get rich? Blessing the Lord makes you rich and adds. No sorry. You ain't got to sign no bonus deals. You ain't got to.
Come on, do nothing.
Just a blessing.
Just a blessing.
That's the only thing that comes out your mouth when you pull up. They come back. What you get that car? The blessing. What? They ain't looking for it. It ain't on the repo list. It's the blessing. I got the title. The house, how you get in the house? The blessing.
The blessing.
Man, your daughter was off the chain 2 years ago. Yeah, now the blessing.
The blessing.
Man, you was overweight a year ago. Yeah, the blessing. I'm living. I decided to live. Who am I talking to this morning? Who am I talking to this morning? See, until you make a decision,
hallelujah,
you won't experience the power of your decision.
Okay.
You know, I want to be healthy.
Yeah.
That's when your eating habits will change. Not just because you caught diabetes and had to go to the emergency room last night. No, I decided. You know, I want to live. I want to be healthy.
You got to decide.
I want to live long.
Yeah.
That's a decision that I made.
Yes,
and now I speak to the Lord, I want your blessing. Come on, say that, Lord, I want.
Lord, I want.
Man, I want your blessing.
Blessing.
Forget all this fighting and struggling and struggling with sweets and struggling with what to eat. And I want your blessing.
Blessing.
I am compatible.
I am compatible.
To your blessing. Now that I decide to live in the blessing of the Lord. My status is changing. Tell your neighbor, my status, my mental status is changing. God's doing
something.
I can't explain. Just keep saying to me, you'll see it, but he's doing something. Hallelujah. On this Good Friday. On this Good Friday, my status is changing. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And listen, I got a word that just dropped in my spirit. This ain't for everybody, because everybody can't. You won't hurt like like that no more. Okay. Okay. That ain't for anybody. That's the only one they ever see. You won't hurt like that. Like how they hurt you. That's awful. You won't hurt like that. No more. You won't hurt like that no more. Now pack up and get out of there. Because you may be still caught up in some hurtful situations. But if you let Christ rise in you, forget everything you lost, forget everything you went through, bless it, close the door, and move forward, you won't hurt like that. Come on, somebody say no more.
No more.
No more. No more. No more. No more hurt. No more hurt. Campaign, no more hurt. Colossians 3. Starting at verse 1. If ye be risen, oh my God, with Christ. If ye be risen with Christ. If ye on this Good Friday be risen with Christ, then you will seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth on the right hand of God. If ye be risen with Christ, if you rise above every earthly situation in your consciousness, in your consciousness, through your consciousness, seek things which are above. You know what's above all things? Love. The Bible says that God is love, so you got to switch to that love. You got to switch to that joy. You got to switch to that peace. You got to switch to that long-suffering. You got to switch to that faith. You got to switch to that meekness. You got to switch to that gentleness. You got to switch to self-control. The Bible says that love never faileth. Christ died for us.
Yes.
Jesus died for us. He died for our sins, yet he never, ever sinned. That's love. That's rising above every situation. And that same capacity, that same level of love is in every believer. That's why he said, let Christ rise in you. You know, it's Passover season and we deal with yeast bread, and it says, you know, we go through the season where for 7 days we eat bread with no yeast. Why? Because yeast rise. You know, you can't cook no biscuits and don't put no yeast in them because they won't rise. So instead of letting sin rise, let Christ rise in your mind.
Yeah.
Come on, say, I am Christ,
the
Son of the living God. Christ is the presence of God
in me.
Christ is the presence of God. 1 Corinthians, I'm telling you, 1 Corinthians, I think it's 1:24. It says, Christ is the power and the wisdom of God. Guess what? That power is in every man. Whether you choose to use it or not, that power is in you. Oh my God. I said, that power is in you. Verse 2, Colossians 3:2. Set your affections on things, there go again, above. Not on things in the earth. Not on distractions in the earth. Not on sickness in the earth. Not on bills in the earth. Set your affections on things above. Set your affections on love. Why? Because it says love never faileth. Even when you're dealing with somebody that's full of sin, it says love will cover a multitude of sin. Wow, love is everything. Love is all we need, y'all. And here you go. Your love won't be tested by people that don't love you back correctly. Did you catch that? So you may be in love with somebody that don't love you. I'm trying to help somebody. That's when you set your things above, you know. I love you enough to leave you. Come on, I'm trying to help you now. I love you enough to leave you, Tim.
Jesus.
You feel me? Then set in a place of despair, a place of disrespect, a place of hurt, harm, and danger. Bible says, be evenly yoked. You feel me? You know, I ran with your unyoked tail long enough. Now I love you to leave you. I'm setting my things above. I'm setting my affections above. You see what I'm saying? Because see, I'm supposed to be experiencing love, joy, and peace. But you, with you, it's love, it's failure, it's fear. You see what I'm saying? I'm experiencing the opposite of love. So that means that I'm in the earth realm, not the spirit realm. Oh my God. Colossians 3:3. For ye are dead, and your life is hid with what? Christ in you. Everything we need happened on the cross. Everything we desire is in Him. It's in Him. You all over the board, get in Him. You confused, get in Him. You scared, get in Him. Oh my God. Verse 4, when Christ, who is our life, oh my God, say that, when Christ, who is our life, shall appear, then shall ye appear with Him in glory. It's about the glory. You can't constantly serve God and the glory don't be on your life. It's like if you go to the trap house or you go to the liquor store every day, guess what? I can look at you and look at them little beaded water eyes and tell you've been on liquor. Well, here you go. If I get in God, oh my God. If I get in Christ, who is my life? I'll come out with glory. Glory is the oxygen of heaven. See, glory is the oxygen of heaven. Heaven ain't got no oxygen. They got glory. Come on, Colossians. We just gonna work Colossians. Colossians 1. Come on, somebody say, let Christ be risen in you.
Let Christ be risen in you.
Hallelujah. Colossians 1, verse 27 and 28. To whom God would make known what is the riches of the glory. Stop right there. Everything you need is in the glory. The glory is what you need when you need it. Come on, say it. The glory is what I need.
When I need.
That's good.
That's the glory.
That's everything I need.
What I need, when I need it. That's the glory.
That's the glory. That's the glory.
Yeah.
That's the glory.
What I need.
What I need.
What I need.
What I need.
That's the oxygen of heaven. To whom God would make known. So once you get in Christ, then He can make known with the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles. So stop right there. God expanded the glory to the Gentiles. See, the Bible says to the Jews first, then to the Greek, but now it's to the Gentiles. That's everybody outside of the Jews and the Greeks. God, like, this glory is for everybody that can switch from humanity to divinity. They can switch from theologically to psychology. There's a richness in my glory, and it's for everybody. It's going to manifest the miracles that you need when you need it. I'm trying to help somebody. Which is the Christ in you? Which is the Christ in you? Which is the Christ in you? It's going back to what's in you. Going back to what's in you, being to say what? The hope of glory.
There go again. So when you show up, the hope show up. When you show up, the glory show up. When you show up, Christ show up. When you show up, blessings show up. When you show up, status change and show up. The glory is an anointing that's on you, and everywhere you go, you're contagious. And when you open your mouth, you can release the glory. The glory is in your mouth.
The glory is in my mouth. I hear you.
The glory is in your heart. From the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. So I speak what's in my heart, and it come out of my mouth, and then it change into earth. But it's all from heaven. Because it ain't me. It's the Christ in me that's coming to you live. Every time I open my mouth, God's glory is being revealed. Why? Because I'm the hope of glory. Come on, say it. I am the hope. I'm the hope of glory. In sickness, I'm the hope of glory. Why? Because by his stripes, I am healed. My God. Come on, we're in Colossians. Go to Colossians 2. Is this heavy to anybody? The presence of God. Somebody say the presence of God. The presence of God in me. The presence of God in me. The kingdom of God is the presence of God in me. Come on, say it. The kingdom of God is the presence of God in me. Right here, right now. Greater is he that is in me than he that's in the world. I believe in myself, and I put God in action. But I believe in myself, and I step out on faith. I put God in action. Why? It's the Christ in me. Tell you that it's just the Christ in me. It's just Christ in me, that's all. How did you know that? How did you? It was Christ in me. It wasn't Derek. It's the Christ in me, Lenora. It's the Christ in me, Kiva. It's the Christ in me, Reba. The home of glory. When I turn my satellite, when I get my satellite off the ground and tune into a high place, in my consciousness, my Christ consciousness. When I tune into my Christ consciousness, nothing will be held back from me. When I yield to the anointing, she's anointing. It's the anointing. It's the anointing that breaks the yoke. So every battle that you have, the anointing gives you victory. The anointing speaks to you. The anointing tells you now, don't call her back. The anointing will give you instruction. And the anointing will give you guidance. The anointing will tell you the name of your company. The anointing will tell you what color shirts to get. The anointing will tell you what to say in your moment of sickness. The anointing will override every geographical law in the earth. Christ is risen. Rise above earthly situations, earthly decisions, and operate in the hope. Operate in the hope. Operate in the hope of glory. Hallelujah. Operate in the hope of glory. Tell your neighbor, operate in the hope